Acetic acid is CH3COH is acetic acid.
So there are many examples of acid. Citric acid, which is present in the liver. There are so many acids. So in general, we have hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, and you will get a nitric acid. Nitric acid. So when you observe something, you are observing.
When you say acids are compounds of hydrogen which release hydrogen ions in water, hydrogen is present here also. H. So hydrogen is present in the last. Hydrogen is present in the sulfuric acid, and hydrogen and nitric acid. In nitric acid there is H initially. So these all are replaced when they react with metals, they produce hydrogen gas. So for that, they are the one which release hydrogen gas when they react to generally metals. Okay. Then now what are the bases? See, bases are the compounds found by the reaction of acid. Bases are produced on a reaction with bases are compounds on reacting with acids which produce salts. For example, NaOH, sodium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, and etc. So attached with this, there is one more word called alkali. And what is an alkali? So basic solutions, an alkali is a base. And alkali is a base. Is a base that dissolves in water. That dissolves in water. So these are in generally water acids and water bases. Did you write down all this? Give you 2 minutes, you can note down so that I can go to next part. And how the metals or how the acids react with metallic oxides. What are actually metallic oxides? Okay. So reaction of metallic oxides with acids. See, but before that you should know what are actually metallic oxides. So these metallic oxides are crystalline solids that contain, so they contain two ions that contains a metal ion, or generally it's a metal which is a cation, okay, and an oxide, so which is anion. So cation is positively charged element, anion is negatively charged element, okay. So to understand this, we have to go for some examples. How they react? How do they react? Okay. So first we will take a beaker. Okay. If you want to conduct experiments, general experiment. First you take a beaker. And to that beaker you add crystals of copper oxide, okay. So to this you add dilute hydrochloric acid. So DIL is dilute hydrochloric acid. Here, when you take copper oxide in a beaker, you should add slowly the hydrochloric acid, so that slowly when you go on stirring, gradually the reaction takes place and there is formation of a blue-green color. And slowly we add hydrochloric acid, and it should be stirring slowly. When you start stirring, gradually the reaction takes place and the solution changes its color to blue green. So that blue green color indicates the formation of copper chloride. Okay. So then we go for the reaction. How does the reaction take place? So first we took copper oxide, it is Cu2O. No, we can take copper oxide CuO. Plus hydrochloric acid is HCl. Okay. So this forms copper chloride CuCl2. CuCl2 copper chloride, and it liberates copper chloride. See, this is the reaction. How does it take place? This forms what? H2O. Now it is imbalance equation. So to balance it, what we have to calculate? First we have to see the number of oxygen atoms in both sides, RHS and LHS. In RHS we have one oxygen atom, here we have one oxygen atom. It is balanced. Okay. And in right hand side, hydrogen two atoms are there, here hydrogen one atom is there. So to make it balance, we have to write 2 here. Now it is correct. 2 hydrogen atoms here, 2 hydrogen atoms, balanced. Copper, only single copper element. 2 chloride atoms, 2 chloride atoms, it is balanced. So below this you should write the names. This is copper oxide. Okay. This is copper chloride. And this turns which color? Blue-green color. Blue-green color. Okay. So this will indicate metal react with acids to form salts, and this formation of salts we will come to know by change in the color. So in this way the reaction takes place. One more example I will give. This is one example. So second example is, how does a sodium, we take sodium oxide. Sodium oxide, Na2O. Will react with sulfuric acid, S2SO4. Okay. So in this reaction take place, again same, you can just draw roughly like this, because negative element and positive element of the interchange each other and form. So they form first of all sodium sulfate, a salt, and water is formed. So here there is no change. Sodium oxide react with sulfuric acid from sodium sulfate and water. So now if you balance oxygen atoms, how many are there? We have O4 plus 1, 5. 5 oxygen atoms in the right hand side, and in the left hand side we have O4 plus O. 5 oxygen atoms. Then hydrogen atoms, how many are there? This side we have S2 and here we have S2O, balanced. So sodium is 2 elements, sodium is 2 elements, balanced. So this is how we have to balance the equations, so that it shows clearly, it indicates clearly the reaction taking place. The resume balance, it does not indicate the reaction taking place, and you may lose marks. So balancing is one of the part, important part of the any chemical reaction. So keep in mind. So here you can write sodium oxide. Will form a precipitate of sodium sulfate. So these two are the reactions where it shows the reaction of metal oxide with acids. Okay. Now we will go for reaction of metal oxides with bases. So directly we cannot go for reaction. So first of all, what we should do? So I'll write here. So next we'll understand the reaction of non-metallic substance with bases. Okay. Reaction of non-metallic oxide with bases. See, directly there cannot be reaction with non-metal and oxide. So initially we have to take acid and base, then we will get the next step wise. Okay. So first we take sodium bicarbonate and react with hydrochloric acid. It forms sodium chloride. Plus H2O plus carbon dioxide. This is one step. So here there is metallic, non-metallic oxide. So this non-metallic oxide is taken and blown. So again this carbon dioxide is passed through calcium carbonate. calcium carbonate. Through this, carbon dioxide is passed. Okay. So this forms 1 meter.